So are you hopeful about this country? I mean, we're at a time where race relations is a big conversation constantly.
I'm supremely hopeful because, you know, when you go through times like this, these are the times that birth the true freedom. These are the times that birth the true justice. Like, unfortunately, people lose their lives. Like, we lost, you know, some of the things that have brought us together and brought the protest is the loss of lives. So some mother has lost her son, and a wife has lost her husband in Eric Garner. And like, but these, you know, their deaths won't be in vain because the change is actually here. People are looking past like, oh, well, it's just a black thing, or this is just a gay thing, or it's just, you know, oh, it's a religious thing. People are young people are out there, middle-aged people out there, elders are out protesting, saying we want to be treated like human beings. We feel every person deserves that right, and to see people ignited and stand up for their rights shows we are in a good place. People can say, man, we in a bad place. We in a good place because the change is coming. We are the change now. Now people are awakened to say, man, we here. We gonna change it. Like, now we know we are the vehicles for change. We the vessels for change. And honestly, you know, maybe a year ago, 2 years ago, maybe 8 months ago, we might have still just been thinking about Instagram. And I mean, but now people using their Instagrams and their Twitters and their voices and their bodies to stand up for something. So, okay, cool. We got the entertainment aspect and yeah, we distracted by some things, but no, we awakened by some things. And this injustice has been going on, and this like oppression has been going on, but it's just been under the table. But now it's like, man, it's out. It's in front of everybody. You can see it. It's the videotape of a man that was not threatening anybody's life with his hands up and telling you he can't breathe. Like, it's not human beings can't look at that and be like, he was threatening that man's life. He was doing anything that, you know, that deserved death. Like, so when things are in front of you, it's like, we gotta face them. And that's what I think, you know, our nation needs. Our nation can't just be like, oh, we got a black president. Hey, y'all, we love. Everything is love. No, it's like, man, it's still prejudice is coming from all nationalities, you know? Because at the end of the day, we were all raised sometimes in separate ways. And with that being said, you just don't have an understanding. Like, you could be a black person that was raised in a neighborhood that was upper economically, you know, like on the higher end of economics, and you may not understand people, black people from poor neighborhoods. Mm-hmm. So understanding is it's not only a color thing. It's like, okay, understanding of people from different backgrounds, and then also forgiveness and acceptance of that. But it got to be put out on the table, and it's like, we got to acknowledge that, you know, America, sometimes we act like everything is beautiful, we politically correct, oh, this is good. But behind closed doors, people still saying different things. And I don't even fault them for it. You know what I'm saying? Because everybody says something.
Yeah.
So I don't fault people for that. I think the thing is, like, how do we get past that now? Okay, let's acknowledge that, shit, I got some problems. I got issues, you know, that I got to get past. So how do I do it? Let's get past it. Let put it out on the table. Let's talk about, like, being amongst each other, getting to a healing place. So that's why I believe America is in a good place. And if we allow our youth to, we use that energy, that's gonna be even better, because the younger generations don't look at color as much as, you know, older generations do.